Hi everyone, and welcome to another episode of Ask, Learn, Grow, the show where the Reef team answer questions and share updates and insights from the digital marketing industry. I've got Head of Performance Media, Matt Yeadon, with me today, and we're going to be keeping with the theme of bidding strategies in Google Ads. So today I think Matt's going to be taking a bit of a deeper dive into two of the most frequently used bidding strategies, which is Maximise Conversions and Target CPA. So we're going to be looking at setting these up and then testing them against each other. So I guess, Matt, to start us off, when would you use Maximise Conversions? And conversely, I guess, when would you use Target CPA? Is there any kind of specific example or case that
you... Yeah, definitely. I think both are vastly different in terms of their approach. And there's some situations where one's advantageous and situations where another is the preferred option to go with. To start with, we'll look at Maximise Conversions, right? So this bidding strategy, it's ideal for accounts where you just want to get as many conversions as possible and you're not too concerned with what your CPA goal is going to be. It's also ideal for accounts where you haven't got any historical conversion data. One advantage with Maximise Conversions is it actually can start without any conversion data in the account, and it doesn't need a minimum per month like some other bidding strategies. So you can just start it running almost immediately and start rolling with it. So it's ideal if you don't really care about the CPA goal initially, and if you have no conversion data in the account, they're also really, really handy for that as well. It's just going to try to get you as many conversions as possible. Target CPA, on the other hand, that's a great tool for optimizing the account toward a CPA target. So that's useful if you've got historical data in the account. So it will need historical data in there, and it does need a minimum number, which I'll go into later, but it does need a minimum number of goals in the account to actually start working efficiently. But that's a great bidding strategy to use if you've got a CPA goal in mind. It's at, for example, I want $60 CPA target. That's where it's really advantageous. So that's where they really differ. So when you're choosing which one to go with, you need to think, do I just want to get as many bids as, or many conversions as possible? Or do I have a target goal in mind? Do I have a CPA goal in mind that would be better and more efficient? So they're the two areas where you would use them.
A realistic CPA goal as well. You can't sell the $60 conversion if you're selling Ferraris, for example.
Exactly. Be nice.
Not going to do that.
Be nice, but it's not going to happen.
All right, cool. So are there any restrictions on Maximise Conversions or Target CPA? Is there any throttles that people should be aware of?
Yeah, so there's restrictions and there's drawbacks to both. To each of those bidding strategies. Maximise Conversions has two major drawbacks that can catch people off guard. The first is that daily budgets can often exceed the daily budget that you've set by 200%. Now, to work towards the monthly target, so say you've got a $3,000 budget, it'll work towards a $3,000 budget, but if you've got a particular client who looks at daily spends, for example, it's not a great strategy to implement, because your daily budget can increase by 200%, and conversely can go the other way. So it might not get as many conversions there on day two as it did on day one, and underspend as a result as it works towards a monthly goal. So that's really the first major drawback of it. The second is it doesn't have a CPA goal in mind. So you're not optimizing for a CPA, so you're kind of losing that control by just trying to get as many conversions through the account as possible within your daily budget or 200% higher. So that's really the two drawbacks to Maximise Conversions. The big one always to call out if you're going to use it with clients is that it can double the spend in a day, but not to panic, because it'll balance itself out throughout the rest of the month. But it can be tricky, especially if you're changing budgets fairly often. The Target CPA bidding strategy, that won't necessarily spend 200% of your daily target, but it might underspend in order to get that CPA goal. So if you've got a client who, for example, has a monthly budget and they don't roll over, so they need to spend that marketing budget, it's worth keeping that in mind. You might actually miss it if the account's trying to optimize towards a lower CPA and in doing so underspends day on day. So that's definitely worth keeping in mind. The second is that the target CPA requires a minimum of 15 conversions every month to actually begin working efficiently. And I said begin, ideally you want 30. You want 30 in there every month to actually have that bidding strategy really work to an optimal level and start getting you down towards a sensible CPA target. Another restriction that doesn't get talked about too much, but is in terms of your budgeting. So if you change the budget after the bidding strategy has already gone through a learning period, it'll actually reset it. And some insights from Google is it'll reset it by as much as 60%. So it'll lose 60% of its value and have to go through 3 to 5 days of learning again, which means you might actually see your CPA skyrocket and then start to come back down. So if you're changing that budget a couple of times a month, you might not ever actually get it to a point where it's working optimally. You need to kind of leave it and let it do its thing. So they're kind of the restrictions or some of the pitfalls of those two bidding strategies you just got to be aware of going into them.
Yeah, and in order to get the most out of some of these sort of automated bidding strategies, you need to understand how the machine learning works, which some of these things that you're going into sort of helps to explain and clarify that. Question for you then, if someone does have a sort of quite a tight CPA budget or target, should we say, but they're getting around 10 conversions a month, would you use a CPA bid strategy if sort of the minimum is generally 15 as a rule of thumb, or what would your advice be there?
I would avoid target CPA with it. What you could look at doing is expanding the goals that you've got. So say you're only focusing on sales qualified leads or sales leads, perhaps looking at other conversions that you could bring into the mix to help bring that up. That would be one way to approach it to get you more conversions to look at per month. But I would probably avoid it if you set of only these conversions and it's only getting about 10 a month, I'd probably avoid it and see if you first can get more conversions coming into the account with maximized conversions and then roll it into target CPA.
So by including more sort of conversions and goals, are we talking about going sort of slightly further up the funnel away from the
app? Yeah, exactly.
And then assigning a dollar value to that as well. And
yep.
Collecting that in.
Cool. Yep.
Yeah, good tip, good advice.
Yeah.
Okay, great. So what would we consider best practice when we're setting up these two bid strategies? Are there differences between the best practice and setting these up? Is it generic?
What is it? So there's a couple of best practices. They actually overlap a lot, which is good. So it makes it pretty easy to roll maximized conversions to target CPA and vice versa. But for both, it's worth identifying early for each campaign what the conversion goal is. By default, Google will just lump all those conversions together. And your campaign, you might have lower funnel activity, right? That's just focused on the sale, but upper funnel activity that's focused on getting a content download, for example. If you're running a lower funnel campaign with maximized conversions or target CPA and you haven't defined what those goals are, it's just going to lump your marketing goals and your sales goals all together and just optimize towards each of them, and it'll just go for whichever one's going to get the most value for them. So it's worth setting that up early. It's really easy to do. All you do is go into your conversion action sets, create a new conversion action set with that goal that you want to track. So it might be a sales lead, it might be a group demo, it might be a sales call, say it's for a lower funnel activity. And then just go into the campaign, go to settings, and then append that, add that as your conversion. And then it'll optimize towards that conversion goal. If you don't do that, it'll just go across all of them. So that's a really easy way to, that's kind of the first thing you do when setting up those campaigns.
So it'll basically assign equal value to all the conversions that you set, unless you group them in specific conversion action sets.
Yeah, by default, it'll just go all conversions and then it'll optimize to everything. And you don't really want all your campaigns optimizing to everything all the time.
No,
you want to separate them out.
Have a huge effect on performance, just that
thing
that you've just shared there.
Yeah, it'd be a nightmare. And then for target CPA, you want to go, like you said before, with a sensible CPA. You don't want to go with a $60 CPA and you're selling a Ferrari or a Porsche or a Lamborghini. It's just not going to happen. And oftentimes people want to optimize towards the best possible CPA they could really get and assume that we've got a bidding strategy. This is machine learning. It should be able to get me a CPA of whatever I give. And it's just not going to work. It just doesn't work like that. It's really a gradual improvement over time. So what I would usually recommend is starting with a 5% reduction on your current CPA and then work your way down from there and see where you can get it to, because there will be a bottom. There will be a bottom to that. You won't be able to get any lower than a particular goal CPA. But it's really just about gradual improvements with target CPA, not just going, let's halve our CPA tomorrow with this target CPA campaign, and then the entire account falls apart because it just can't optimize towards that efficiently.
Great advice. So just to finish off the call then, last question. Are there any pitfalls or gotchas that marketers and advertisers should be aware of with these bid strategies?
Yeah, the biggest one is that people just assume they can set and forget it, and that's it. So I've set a bidding strategy, let's leave this thing to run and do its thing. It definitely doesn't work like that. Bidding strategies are a tool, they're not a replacement for the advertiser. You need to continue optimizing your keywords, your ad copy, all of your creative needs constant work. You also need to constantly review those bidding strategies. So that comes into testing them against one another to see which one's the most efficient for the account. But you can't just set and forget it. And I think it's one of the biggest mistakes people make is the bidding strategies. Some people get a little bit lazy with them and just leave them to run and just kind of hope for the best. And it just doesn't work like that. The second most common pitfall that I see is not setting up conversion action sets, which you just discussed. Maybe not too many people are aware of it, but it's vitally important that you set those up in your campaigns. Otherwise, they're not really going to have the effect that you want. So setting up conversion action sets would be the second biggest pitfall, next to just assuming you can set and forget them.
Cool. Thanks ever so much, Matt, for sharing all this great information about the Maximise conversions and target CPA bid strategies. That kind of wraps up today's call. So if anyone's got any questions about today's topic or any digital marketing related question for that matter, please send them in and we're always happy to help. If you've got a burning question you'd like to put to the team, feel free to send those in too, and we'll see what we can do. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel to be notified of when the next video is available. Thanks all for watching and enjoy the rest of your day.